The Lord.
We must first be revived.
And
now the intentions of God shall be fulfilled on the earth. There is something that was taken away from us that was so precious. Some of the things that were taken away from us, it is to love God. Now to love God and being in the image of God, there are very important matters if you are to minister to God. But now the devil deceived us. We love so much ministering and we left the character. Now character and the love of God, they were not in us. So the rest tuba tubanga abayamba obuyamba bakore mirimo ja nachewa. But even the Muslims do charitable works. Even Indians do charity works. But the intention and the purpose,
selfish,
they belong to the devil. They say they are giving to receive the blessing. So meaning they are dedicating you.
And
they unaddress all their spells for them to get blessing. That is the character of the devil.
Praise the Lord. And
that one makes no sense. Now here the character of God. The first one is love. And humility.
God is about God.
God does good always to his people. The heart of God is always people. For people to be well off.
Hallelujah.
That is the heart of God. Not oppressing others. So we had lost the character of God. And we had sin.
Abooluganda, HIV, sin casts you away from God's presence. And sin,
it strips you and it even blinds eyes. You can't even see where you're going. Sin kills visions. It kills destiny. It kills important relationships.
So you will be always stagnant.
Like how the children of Israel were in the wilderness.
So we must deal
with everything that embodies with us, that we may connect with God, that we may enjoy his salvation. Children of God, when we lost the image of God and we never put the focus on it, life became so hard. Life was not there. So we became a reproach, a disgrace. But praise be to our God, who is reviving things. In this conference, we shall all be revived. And we shall not remain the same. And we shall reach into our destinies.
Hallelujah.
The Holy Spirit, as we hear him, the Holy Spirit, he's a spirit who is holy.
Ah,
and
the fallen tabernacle of David.
He wants to dwell in this tabernacle
that had fallen. God wants to restore it.
So that purpose builds life.
No, bulamu bwo omutima ogutuukiridde ogwa Katonda.
It concerns your spirit, your soul, your heart that connects with God.
Tusobola okukwatagana ne Katonda.
That we may connect with God.
Kati njagala kwogera ku kibi.
Now I want to speak about sin.
Ekyetaaga kyetwetaaga okusumulwamu to be purged.
That we need to be purged from.
Ekibi ekyo nga kye kibi eky'obwenzi.
And that is a sin of immorality. Praise the Lord. If we don't repent for the sin of immorality, according to the scriptures we are going to see, it has captivated many things. There are two kinds of immorality. There is this immorality of the body, of the flesh, and there is also last thing. When our hearts are not connected to God.
So whatabera kwechibera Jezebel ya kulire chibi.
Jezebel is a leader of sin.
Omoyo mutukuvu bwetuba gwabakomawo okutuula.
When the Holy Spirit is restored.
Sigamba the spirit around, ngamba the spirit within.
I am not talking about the spirit on, but the spirit in.
Not the spirit upon, but the spirit within.
So your moya kugwako, na yo moya ari munda mugwe.
Yes, ato yo moyo yari mugwe akolagana na bibala.
And the spirit within you brings fruit.
Your character.
It is with character the fruit.
So aboluganda.
Brethren.
Jezebel.
Jezebel.
The principality.
Oh, you are masters.
And the destroyer of nations.
Aweyazikiriza amawanga.
Mukama gwayagala.
That the Lord wants to deliver us from. That the church may bring the God's governance on the earth. Holy Spirit, we want to honor you. Because you are taking us deeper.
Let's go together in Revelation 8.
18.
Revelation 18. From verse 3 to 9.
Tujatanika kulokusatu paka kulomwenda. Before we do anything, we shall first pray for Israel. Humble yourselves as we pray for Israel. Father, we remember Israel. Everybody is the head of the church and is the center of all the earth. As a church, we connect with you through your firstborn, Israel. We pray for his deliverance from the sin of immorality that he connected with,
or
from the spirit of Baal and the so-called queen of heaven. Deliver him, and as well as a church, deliver our nation and all the nations from the spirit of Jezebel, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God.
Amen.
And everybody says amen.
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 Uh-huh.
Amen.
Revelation 18, from 3 to 9.
I read.
Kubanga olw'omwenge gw'obusungu bw'obwenzi bwe, amawanga gonna gagudde, ne bakabaka b'ensi ne bayenda naye, n'abatunzi b'ensi ne bagaggawala olw'amaanyi g'obukaba bwe. Ne mpulira eddoboozi eddala eriva mu ggulu nga lyogera nti, mukifulumemu abantu bange, muleme okussa ekimu n'ebibi bye, era muleme okuweebwa ku bibonyoobonyo bye. Kubanga ebibi bye bituuse mu ggulu, era Katonda ajjukidde ebyonoono bye. Mukaaga. Mumusasule oyo nga bwe yasasula, era mwongereko emirundi ebiri ng'ebikolwa bye bwe byali. Mu kikompe kye kye yatabula, mumutabulire emirundi ebiri nga bwe yeegulumiza n'akabawala. Mumuwe bwe mutyo okubonaabona n'okunakuwala. kubanga ayogera mu mutima gwe nti ntudde nga kabaka so siri namwandu so siraba nnaku n'akatono. Munana.
Koma kumwenda.
Kyebiriva bijja mu lunaku olumu ebibonyoobonyo bye okufa n'ennaku n'enjala era alyokerwa ddala omuliro kubanga Mukama Katonda w'amaanyi eyamusalira omusango era bakabaka b'ensi abayenda ne bakabawala naye balikaaba balikuba ebiwoobe ku lulwe bwe baliraba omukka ogw'okwokebwa kwe.
And then I read in English. Revelation chapter 18 from verse 3. For all the nations have drunk of the wine of the wrath of her fornication. The kings of the earth have committed fornication with her, and the merchants of the earth have become rich through the abundance of her luxury. Verse 4. And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people, lest you share in her sins, and lest you receive of her plagues. For her sins have reached to heaven, and God has remembered her iniquities. Verse 6. Render to her just as she rendered to you, and repay her double according to her works. In the cup which she has mixed, mix double for her. Verse 7. In the measure that she glorified herself and lived luxuriously, in the same measure give her torment and sorrow. For she says in her heart, I sit as a queen and am no widow, and I will not see sorrow. Therefore, her plagues will come in one day, death and mourning and famine. And she will be utterly burned with fire, for strong is the Lord who judges her. Verse 9. The kings of the earth who committed fornication and lived luxuriously with her will weep and lament for her when they see the smoke of her burning.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Nabagambye nti tugenda kudilinga ne Jezebel.
I told you we are going to deal with Jezebel.
Ngera bwe tulabye.
As we have seen.
Nti naba kyalambwa asudde amawanga amangi.
She has made many nations to fall.
Asudde bakabaka.
She has made many kings to fall.
Asudde abasajja ba Katonda.
She has fallen the king, the men of God.
Asudde abakazi ba Katonda.
She has fallen the women of God.
Asudde destroyer of destinies.
He has killed amagenda.
Mukama yebazi.
Praise the Lord.
Kati mukudiri okumanya mukama muina ko busungu.
To know that God has wrath upon her.
Atugambye nti tumukube mfe tumukutabulire chikompe mirundi echi.
He has said that we mix double for her.
Ngabo yatukuba fe nafe tugenda mukuba.
As she beat us, we shall also beat her down.
Yeita waamani.
She calls herself strong.
Na ye Katonda wafembwa alina amaanyi agasinga.
But the Lord who judges her is more stronger.
Kati omukazi ono Jezebel.
Now this lady called Jezebel.
Ayitira mu bwenzi.
She connects.
Akozesezza ekibi eky'obwenzi.
She has used the sin of immorality.
Okutusiba.
To bind us.
Kati tugenda kukisima.
So we are going to dig deep.
Tulabe ekitabo kya Ngero. Proverbs 31.
Let's go to Ngero asatu mwem.
From verse 2 to 6.
Okulobiripaka.
The Bible says that we are the temple of the Holy Spirit.
But the Lord rebukes the immoral and adulterers. Yes.
Engero hasatu muemu olwokubiri. Chichi mwana wange. Era chichi ayo mwana olubuto lwange. Era kiki ayi omwana w'obweyamu bwange. Towanga bakazi amaanyi go newankubadde amakubo go eri ekyo ekizikiriza bakabaka. Si kwa kabaka ayi lemweri, si kwa bakabaka okunywanga omwenge, so si kwa balangira okwogeranga nti ekitamiza kiri luddawa.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Paka ku mukaaga.
Balemenga okunywa ne beerabira amateeka ne banyola omusango gw'omuntu yenna abonyaabonyezebwa. Mukaaga. Mumuwenge chitamizo ya yagalo kufa. No muengoyo aline memeri kobu yinike.
Mukama yebazibu.
Amen.
To wangamanyi go.
That never give your strength.
Eriyo mukazo omwenzi.
To the adulterous woman.
Buliayenda chiba chitegeza amanyi go na.
Whoever does immorality, meaning that he has given his strengths.
Agobu vubuka.
The strengths of the youth.
Ne future yonabaji wati.
And all the future he has committed
it. Agobu omwenzi wambula amanyi.
Brethren, adultery strips of strengths.
Tugenda kulaba ebyawandikibwa.
We are going to see scriptures.
Nga fena.
When all of us.
Nga ebimu ebintu ebikulu ennyo bye tulina okussaako omwoyo.
That the important thing we must put our focus on.
Kwekuma.
Is to keep ourselves.
Obutagwa mu bwenzi.
Not to fall into adultery.
Naye ate bwe twesanga fena twesanga nga twazaalibwa mu bwenzi.
But when we search around ourselves, we find
ebyobwenzi.
We are all victims of immorality.
Tugenda okwekanga nga bakitaffe ne bamaama nga fena tuli products.
Our fathers and our mothers were all products.
Nga tuliko rejection.
And we have rejection.
At a certain degree.
Nga ebigera ebyenjawulo.
Nga okubikulula okw'obwa Katonda nga kizibu.
The revelation of God is hard for us.
Okufuna omukisa nga kizibu.
To get a blessing is hard for us.
Kati ngenda kwogera ku bibi obwenzi kyebuleeta.
I'm going to speak about the sins attached to immorality and adultery.
Obwenzi buletera obuletera it causes failure.
Okulemererwa.
And rebel against God.
No kujemera Katonda.
Sin
HIV
brings wounds
kireta ebiwundo
that are incurable
ebyebitawona.
Abantu abasinga balina obusungu n'ekirui.
Many people have wrath and bitterness.
Chiva kubwenzi.
It comes from this sin of immorality and fornication.
Tulabe kitabo kyange sura mukaga.
Let's go to Proverbs chapter 6.
Nga tetunaba kugenda yeyo.
Before we go there.
Bible egamba mu kuvabiri.
The Bible tells me in Exodus chapter 20.
Olunyoro 14.
Verses 14.
Titoyendanga.
That they never commit adultery.
Teka.
It is a command.
Mm-hmm.
Engero mukaga.
Engero mukaga. Olusoka.
Engero mukaga vwa kulwa satu.
You begin from verse 30.
Proverbs 6, 30. Abantu tebanyoma mubbi oba ngabba okukusememeye ngalumiddwa enjala. Naye bw'anaalabikanga anaagattanga emirundi musanvu. Anaawangayo ebintu byonna eby'omu nnyumba ye. Ayenda ku mukazi talina kutegeera. Ayagala okuzikiriza obulamu bwe yakola bw'atyo. Alifuna ebiwundu n'okunyomebwa n'ekivume kye tekirisangulibwa.
Gamba wamma kyekino ekivume ekimba.
So this is a reproach upon me.
Kubanga tata yayenda ne
my grands, my fathers all fornicated.
Abooluganda lekera awo bino byobadde osababa tebampa kitiibwa.
Stop commanding respect.
Banyoomanyooma tebandabawo.
People don't respect me, they don't honor me.
Leero tufunye solution.
Today we get the solution.
Tugenda kubeera paged.
Tugenda kulongosebwa.
Ekisa wekiri.
The grace is abiding.
Omwoyo mutukuvu agenda kutusumulula mu kibi ekyobwenzi.
The Holy Spirit is going to deliver us from the sin of
ekyobwenzi.
And also the curse of adultery.
So sin brings failure in marriage.
Kati ekibi kiri eta okulemererwa mu bufumbo.
It brings failure in business.
Okulemererwa mu by'emirimo.
It brings failure in ministry.
Kiri eta okulemererwa mu buweereza.
And brings failure in relationships.
Atene munkore gana.
And greatness.
Kiziyiza n'obukulu.
And godly connections.
N'enkoleganizo bwa Katonda.
The sin of fornication and adultery.
Ekibe ky'obwenzi n'obukaba.
It is pagan.
Kyabukafi.
It causes you to rebel against God's law.
Kikuleetera okujeemera etteeka lya Katonda.
And it refutes you to be disciplined.
Ate kikuziyiza n'okubanga onenyezebwa.
Sin causes you.
Ekibi ekyo kikuleetera.
to be mental. It is the sexual sin that brings mental and social. Mental disorders. All this is from scripture. It is in scripture. It brings this, the sexual sin brings destruction and failure at the age.
No, kuremererwa ku myaka.
You die young.
Ofango ochali muto.
It is this sin, the sexual sin, that causes shame, it brings shame, dishonor. It goes even on the land, according to Jeremiah 23:10 and 11. Please go there.
Katugendeyo.
Yeremia abiri musatu olwekumi. Kubanga ense Juda abenzi, kubanga ense kungubaga olwokulayira. Amarundiro ag'omuddungu gakaze. N'amagenda gaabwe mabi, n'amaanyi gaabwe si malungi. 11. Kubanga nabbi era ne kabona bononefu. Weewaawo mu nnyumba yange mwe nalabira obubi bwabwe, bw'ayogera Mukama.
Olaba kyengeza kugamba.
You see what I'm trying to say.
Bakabona ffe tuyina okwenenya.
It is us the priest who must repent first.
N'ensolo ne tulinze na Yesu mu lulwe.
When the earth is also waiting for us to be delivered.
Agambye amalundiro.
He says,
gonna gaganye gafudde. N'ettaka liganye okumera.
Even the land has refused to yield. For the sin of
the church is responsible
to hit this serpent of Jezebel that brings adultery and fornication.
Praise the Lord. This sin of adultery, fornication, the sexual sin brings financial failure and poverty. Let's see Proverbs 5:9. If it is not dealt with properly, even in salvation, if we have not repented and disconnected ourselves from this spirit of
Jezebel,
we can even miss God's timing and the good things that and the good plans God has for us. Because it even kills visions and causes blindness.
Engero tano.
Mwenda.
Olwo mwenda.
Nolwe kumi.
Olemengo kuwa abalala ekitiibwa kyo n'emyaka gye eri omukambwe. Abagenyi balemenga okukuta amaanyi go. N'emirimu gyo giremenga okubeera mu nnyumba y'omunnaggwanga. Naawe n'onakuwala enkomerero yo ng'etuuse.
So this
sin kills destinies.
When you read Proverbs 5
and Proverbs 6,
they talk
about the sin of immorality.
And
she has thrown many kings. It has caused many kings to fall. It has caused many ministers to fall. The ministers of God. The princes. The great apostles.
The businessmen.
The great businessmen.
The professionals.
The great professionals. They have all fallen. We have seen in Revelation 8, that all nations have fallen because of his adultery. She has caused adultery to them and blinded their eyes. She knows that in the as long as she connects into your destiny and she frustrates your businesses
na frustrating obufumbo
and she frustrates your marriage,
of course our family tewali,
so there is no family
kati mukama munako ezoluvanyi.
So God in the later days
aina plan yokukomya our family.
He has a plan to restore our family.
Yes, ongalwachera yatukomezao.
It's the reason why we have come back home,
church family,
amaka aga church and the real family. It's my prayer
homecoming
that in this homecoming some of us we lost our fathers, others we lost our mothers, others we are real orphans. But even the church,
orphan spirit,
when the father is calling us back home, but the foundations, the foundation of the church is working upon them. So even in the church we never cared to hit the Jezebel, the serpent. We came to know about prosperity, what we need, what is God going to do for me. But we never knew about his purpose. So we have been praying amiss, and that's why we failed. And we saw no result. Yet this powerful girl, we have seen in this scripture that never give your strength to this adulterous woman. Maybe for you never committed adultery, but your father and your mother and your forefathers,
product.
So you are now a product of immorality. This woman has a contact with you. That's why things are hard. We have seen that. In Revelation chapter 2, he says that if we don't repent, he's going to take away the lamp.
Revelation 2 verse 22.
You don't need to tolerate Jezebel. You have to cast her out and repent of her action. Most of us we don't repent of her actions according to what our parents
did.
The physical parents and the spiritual parents, there is immorality in the church. What can disconnect us, deliver us from her actions? And it is not just getting delivered from demons as we've been doing. Not just raising our hands and we ask for a blessing, ask, give me my car, give me my house,
Omwami Haiti,
American Haiti man, give me
omchara nsingo bisera ope,
a brown woman, give me. After receiving the wife, you ask for
child.
So you are like saying God has no purpose for creating you. That is Jezebel. Jezebel had sat in the church and even all her doctrines. We have been feeding on her food.
She
says that we should neglect her, that God people should abandon Jezebel.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. And we should beat her. We should beat her double.
Revelation 2.
Okubikulirwa 2:22. Laba musula ku kiriri n'abo abenda naye mu kubonaabona okungi bwe batenenya mu bikolwa bye.
If they don't repent of their deeds, adultery brings tribulation.
You see
the suffering you have been going through, and you have been blaming that your auntie bewitched you, your stepmother bewitched you, your uncle and even your neighbor. But your parents, they bore you in adultery.
When
we see the beginning of man, it was God.
Katonda ye yatesa.
It is God who purposed.
Natula.
He planned.
Nagamba tutondo muntu mungeri.
He said, let us create man in our image.
Mungeri in his image.
Muchifanani mungeri.
Mwe yamutondera.
He created him.
Omusajja n'omukazi.
A man and a woman.
Nabagamba bafuge.
And he told them to reign.
Nabawa omukisa.
He blessed them.
Bwe yatuuka wali olwo eyo yonna process.
When he started narrating,
he gave
him the garden and gave him responsibility to tend over the garden. When you go to verses 18, chapter 12 of Genesis, he caused Adam to fall asleep. After creating them in the spirit, in chapter 1 of Genesis, now in Genesis chapter 2 verse
7,
he praised in him and created the flesh. In verses 18, God is still planning. And plan for him a good wife. Who plans for a good companion?
Adam.
So they caused Adam to sleep. And they took his rib out. So by the time he got awake, so he discovered this, a wife aside.
Bone of my bones.
Nagambe gumbaria gumbariange.
And flesh of my what?
Amubiri gumubiri gwange.
Ani akolo ebyo byonna?
Who is doing all that process?
Naye Adam wazula. Adam wazula buzuzi.
Adam is just discovering what God. When God has planned for him. So if it is like so, it means that all wisdom and understanding comes from God. So his purpose is getting fulfilled. And in verses 24
it
says, so the man shall leave his father and his mother and join with his wife, and they shall become one flesh. And the purpose will be fulfilled for them to
dominate.
So your father and your mother, I don't know about yours, but let me give you my story. Who was the one who was my father?
Yanza, first born.
He birthed me, I'm the first born.
Kakati bali kusomero.
They were at school with
mama wange yali mu S2.
So my mother was in senior 2.
Ngo muvubuka ali mu S4.
And the father was in senior 4.
Kakati ne obaba agwa mbitoke.
So they fell into a relationship, but I don't know whether in a banana plantation.
Kubanga Bible yegamba.
Because the Bible says
ekitanda kirongofu.
So that the bed is clean.
Obufumbo bwakitiibwa.
The holy marriage.
Ne ekitanda kirongofu.
And the holy bed.
Naye ayogera atya kubikundi eri 13. Naye anenya abakaba n'abenzi.
But he rebukes the adulterers and fornicators.
Kati bano bali bafumbo bano.
So as easy school boys and school children.
Bali kitanda kirongofu.
Are they married? Are they in a holy bed?
Kale, mama yatwala tata ewuwe ewabwe.
So
oba tata ye yaleta kuzi ewabwe bazadde bene ba consenting
abu. Is it my mother who took my father to their home, or my father brought my mother to their
home?
It was lasting.
Wali kola chi?
It was all about lasting.
Yegomba akawala akachi.
He just admired the young girl.
Nga tebanachu premature.
Nga tebanatuuka bakyali bato.
Era ekindaga nti bali premature.
And what shows me that bali bakyali bato.
Banyumiza mbu ebiseera ebyo Idi Amin yali akola ki? Omulenzi bw'afunisa omuwala tanaba kwetuuka.
So during those days of Idi Amin,
nga bamusiba.
When you could commit
kati yali tata wange n'adduka Kenya.
So my father ran to Kenya away from being arrested. Amen.
So though
I'm a great servant of God, so there is rejection upon that
project.
I have a rebuke.
Praise the Lord.
Gamba mean.
Siri kocha kunenyezebwa.
There is a condemnation.
Kubanga ndi product ya mukaba na bwenzi.
Because I'm a product of fornication and immorality.
Kati omusoto ogwo gwa Jezebel yo.
That serpent of Jezebel.
Bwenzi ja mukanisa.
When I come to church.
Mukama nsubira okubera nga ntandika okudiringa nebyo.
God expects me to deal with that foundation first. What he said in here
is
that the actions of Jezebel, they don't just hit the demons. They don't just hit the demons of poverty, the demons of rejection, and the demons of not prospering.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
You
have to repent for the deeds of Jezebel for you to be delivered. What does he say in Exodus chapter
20?
You read from verses 5 of Exodus chapter 20.
Okuva abiri olw'okutaano. Tobivunamiranga ebyo so tobiweerezanga. Kubanga nze Mukama Katonda wo, ndi Katonda wa bujja, abiwalana ku baana ebibi by'abajjajja baabwe okutuusa ku mirembe egy'okuba nakasatwe ne ku bannakana.
So he pays the sins of the fathers up to the fourth and the third generation. Can jump to 14.
Toyendanga.
He says, don't commit that sin of adultery.
Tata ne mama, teyafuna mchala mutufu.
So if the father never and mother never went through holy matrimony,
obosiwe nzina bukaba,
that is adultery and fornication.
Yafuna bufunyi kwegomba bwegombi kwa maso.
They just lusted with their eyes.
Fenna abooluganda tuli products tujja kugwa jjajja nazaala abaana simanyi nkaaga mu mmeka Kenya ewa ebyo Mukama byayagala.
Is that what God wants?
Kati ababaana bonna beyazaala tuli byana yana
bya. So all the children my father produced were just kati
atuwo omukisa guguno guze atujjayo atuyita atuleeta eri obulokozi.
The opportunity has come, he is calling us back, he calls us to salvation.
Kasita tuyingira mu bulokozi.
The moment we enter,
nga tutandika obuvunaanyizibwa okulwokulwana n'omusota ensigo y'omukazi kyekigambo kya Katonda.
We begin the responsibility of dealing with a serpent, that is the word of God.
Kati wano tuli mu kukudiringa na musota kati.
We are right now dealing with a serpent.
Omusoto omutufu.
The true serpent.
Jezebel.
Jezebel.
Satan.
The
omuli oliomi.
The accuser of brethren.
Omulimba wa mawanga.
The liar of all nations.
Akaba waza abanji.
Who causes the adultery.
Asunde bakabaka.
He has fallen the kings.
Naba man.
And the great people.
The professionals.
The professionals.
Tamanyi na basajja bakatonda kastote enenya mubwe.
He doesn't know that you are a great man of God if you don't repent of his deeds.
Okwenenya chitege.
Repentance means a turnaround.
Aboluganda ekibi.
Present sin.
Ekibadde muffe.
That had engulfed in us.
Gwe musota Mukama gwayagala
tukule. Something that God wants us to deal with.
Tuddeyo mu kifaananyi kye.
And be restored into his image.
That is what they call revival.
Ekyo kye bayita okudda obuggya.
Revival means ekintu kyaliwo.
Meaning something was there originally.
Bringing back something into use.
Oh, no, kikomyawo kubanga kigasa.
So that means something was there.
Waliwo
ekituufu ekiriwo.
The right thing was there in the beginning.
Nekivaawo.
It was taken away.
Kati ffe abantu.
Now
twatondebwa mu kifaananyi kya Katonda.
Created in the image of God.
Twagala kuddayo.
We want to be restored.
Mukyatwagaza tuddeyo mutuku ne mutuku.
He wants us to go back into holiness and righteousness.
Amaanyi gano ag'okuba omusota.
This assault of hitting the serpent.
Tusobole okufuga.
That we may reign.
Omusota ogwali gwamira ebyaffe.
The serpent had swallowed all our possessions.
Gwali gwamira destinies.
He had swallowed the destinies.
Nga gwatusiba.
And bound us.
Nga gwatutte.
and poisoned us. We ourselves will have the poison of the serpent.
For the cause
we don't repent. We don't repent of the deeds of Jezebel, of the serpent. Those who have just come.
We began with Revelation
18.
And we are dealing
with
Jezebel, the destroyer of nations.
Jezebel
is the snake they told us to deal with. Right there from the fall, when man fell. Praise the Lord. And we have connected with Jezebel. And we have danced with this snake. And we have tolerated it for many years. But now, when we know the truth, the truth shall set us free. Hallelujah.
Amina.
For sure, this snake, it has caused us to be irresponsible, and it has caused us to be stagnant.
Things are not moving.
Praise the Lord.
Gamba mina. We have seen that this serpent, it causes wounds into. Now it has poisoned you. Because we tolerated it, we prayed around with it. Instead of hitting it,
shame and dishonor.
And this
snake,
through
sexual sin,
has caused
us to be compromisers.
And when
we compromise, you are vulnerable to every sin and every temptation you can never overcome unless you decide to deal with it. So this compromise, compromising with Jezebel, has caused us to be robbed of our wealth and our destinies. Praise the Lord. Our Uganda destinies are important to redeem. It has caused us to have achievements in life. And it has robbed us of God's vision and direction.
This evil spirit,
this sexual sin,
if
not repented of very well, we have seen in Deuteronomy 22:22 that it brings destruction and death at the point of success.
I am always almost there, and I don't get there. Why don't I always succeed? I don't always reach to the end.
Sexual sin. We need to be. The Holy Spirit is here.
To purge us.
Of this sexual sin. In the name of
Jesus.
Are you there?
Ekyamateeka abiri mu bbiri abiri mu bbiri.
Deuteronomy 22:22.
Bwe baasanganga omusajja ng'asula n'omukazi eyafumbirwa bba, bombi bafenga omusajja eyasula n'omukazi n'omukazi, bw'otyo bw'onojjanga obubi mu Isirayiri.
So sexual sin brings destruction and death. And there is no continuity. But it's a legacy.
chebaita omukululo tukubawo mu bulamu
obubanga family legacy
omukululo mu family tukubawo nga
when we do not deal with this sexual sin properly
bwetubanga tetulwanya na kibi kino ekyobwenzi
there will not be family legacy
tuwabawo omukululo mu families
let's see Hosea 4:4
tulabe Hosea esulanya
both in the Old Testament
wonna mu ndagaano enkadde
and in the New Testament
ne mu ndagaano empya
sexual sin
ekibi ekyobwenzi
we see that it causes many it is a very serious door
rugira onene nyo
for the snake
oluyingizwa omusota
for failure
oluleeta okulemererwa
and all the struggles
n'okubanga tufuba mu bulamu
praise the Lord
gamba amina
because it takes you away from God
kubanga kikujja Katonda
it displaces you
kikujja mu kifo kyo
and it takes you
era kikutwara
to the place of destruction
mu kifo ky'okuzikirira
where we are not supposed to be
ngwe tutateke
That is not our portion.
Ogwesukwe mungabo gwafe.
Aha. Gamyeje.
Koseya nya olwokuna.
Nokuru 14.
Koseya nya olwokuna. Siribonereza abawala bammwe bwe befuula abenzi. Ne wankubadde abagole bammwe bwe bakabawala. Kubanga bo bennyini beyawula n'abakazi abatambuzi.
Praise the Lord. Aha.
N'abantu abatategeera balisuulibwa.
Obwenzi bumalamu amagezi.
So immorality takes away wisdom.
N'okulekebwawo.
And you are abandoned.
Okusuulibwa eri.
You are rejected.
By God and by people.
Abantu ne Katonda.
Waberanga we chikoli mecha echiva ngabachi kukoli muntu akukoli midene echikoli mechive wa Katonda.
Some human being can curse you but they curse from God.
Echo techijibwawo benenya chenenye.
There is no other deliverance apart from repentance.
Ato kwenenya.
And repentance.
It's an attitude.
Evera ndoza mba.
Ya era ya weto was still kudayo mumbaga ya Katonda.
That's going back to the character of God.
Kati olujiru no lwobwenzi.
Now this door of immorality.
Kwetululeka nga lugule.
When we leave it open.
Echikompe okuvira dala mu bajeje 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 abo.
The cup from your four parents.
Twalabye mu Jeremiah nagamba nensi yonna eyenze.
He says all the nations have fornicated.
Bwe wabera we kibi kye twetaaga okwenenyanga ku kyoto serious.
If there is ever be a sin to repent at the altar.
Kye kibi ekyobwenzi.
That is a sin of immorality.
Ekanisa ebyoto ebyoto binebye ebyamadala ebyamabala nebye bimansulo.
The church instead of these altars of lodges bars and
Baba kuwa sadaka omukazi ono omwe.
They are just sacrificing to this woman Jezebel.
Kati Bible egamba ekanisa yange neberanga nyumba ya kusabira mu kulwa mawanga gonna.
The Bible says my house my church shall be a house of prayer for all nations.
Ekanisa botuba twajijjamu okusabiranga amawanga.
If we stopped as a church for praying to nations.
Echo nacho kuva kumulamwa.
That is also perversion.
Nga tusabiramu byanfuna byokka byange byenjagala byenjayanira kwaka.
We are only praying for prosperity. That is also lasting.
Praise the Lord.
Gamba amen.
Kati tubadde n'omukazi ono nga tuzina naye.
So we have been dancing with this lady Jezebel. We have not been dealing with her.
Gwe musoto ogulabika oba otero ogulaba omusota nga gunyirira.
And that is the beautified serpent you always see.
Bw'ogulaba gundi yako gunyuma okwatako naye nga mulungi.
When you see its appearance it looks good, beautiful, but it's not good.
Gunyirira gumasamasa.
It is so glittering and beautiful.
Naye ne bw'egunaamasamasa butya it is dangerous.
But no matter how it glitters, gwabulabe jori.
Era twaweebwa assignment okugukuba.
And we're given an assignment to deal with it.
Tukirabye okugukuba si kwe kuguba ogolera kubanga tubadde tuyina enkwaso nago.
It is not just rebuking it away and casting it away, but you have to repent because
yes, yagamba bagundi wali mu Mateya 2:3 is it? Nagamba mwebyana by'omusota meaning n'abantu bayinza okubeera emisota.
Jesus told the Pharisees that you brood of vipers, meaning we human beings we can be
Naswe kanisa one way or the other tubadde byana bya musota kubanga tubadde bannaddiini mu kanisa kanisa inakuba musota so si good tolerating kitegeza naffe tubadde mu bannaddiini.
In one way or another we have been a brood of vipers because we have been religious tolerating
ng'ebikolwa byaffe byonna tebikwatagana ne Yesu.
All our actions are not connected to Jesus.
Naye nga eki omulyango oba n'omulandira ogubadde guleeta ekibi obutakiwangula gwe mulandira gw'obwenzi nga tegwerenyezeddwa
bulungi. The door and the root that have been bringing causing us to fail is so, the sin of immorality.
This sexual sin,
kino ekibi ekyobwenzi,
it blocks God's blessings.
Kiziyiza emikisa gya Katonda.
And gives you stress. Stressful emotions.
Praise the
Lord.
Amina. And you have been complaining of stress all the time. The Bible has never taken us to that place of okubera n'ebirowoozo
ebitawaanya.
In all the Holy Scriptures,
ayogera nti stress kikoli.
He says that okuba n'ebirowoozo ebyo ebikukyankalanya, that is a curse.
Okugweddalu n'okutabuka.
Being confused and disorderly.
Kikoli mu naye ffe twabizunguwaza.
It is a curse, but for us we have made it normal.
Kati omanyi tekiri mu n'atamanyi luzungu mwatu amanyi stress.
No, even somebody who doesn't know English can speak of stress as if it is something normal, precious. Amina.
Banange ninazi stress zange.
You know, I have some stresses.
But it is a curse.
Nenga chikori mwecho choweyogera ko.
Nechikuletera bi stress ebyo bwenzi.
And what the origin of those stresses in immorality? If you don't repent very well.
Obwenzi nobukaba.
Immorality and fornication.
But what if it is not repented of very well? We need the church needs purging.
Ekanisa yetaago okulongosebwa.
Real purging.
Okulongosebwa kwaddala.
Praise the Lord.
Gamba amina.
So this sin.
Ati kino ekibi.
Dayo tusomere Proverbs 5:9.
Tuddeyo mu ngero 5:9 twadde twasomere.
Kale ba ku lw'omunaana.
Begin from verses
8.
And it shall stop on 11.
Ngero 5 lw'omunaana. Ekkubo lyo limwesambire ddala.
Kale va wali waggulu ku lw'okutaano.
From verse 5.
Ebigere bye bikka mu kufa. Ebisinde bye bikwata amagombe. N'okulaba talaba kkubo terevu ery'obulamu.
Olaba bwe kiziba amaaso.
It brings eyes.
Olaba okufa we kuli awo.
There is death there.
Amakubo ge gasagasagana.
Meaning you thought in no wonder obadde tonywerera na mbulokozi
tonywerera
kya kuteesa.
Ekyewuunyisa, you are not stable in salvation.
Amakubo ge gasagasagana so takimanyi. Kale nno baana bange mumpulirenga. So temuvanga mu kigambo. Mu bigambo eby'omukamwa kange. Ekkubo lyo limwesambire ddala. So tosembereranga luggi lwa nnyumba ye. Olemenga okuwa abalala ekitiibwa kyo n'emyaka gyo eri omukambwe. Abagenyi balemenga okukuta amaanyi go n'emirimu gyo giremenga okubeera mu nnyumba y'omunnaggwanga. 11. Naawe n'onakuwala enkomerero yo ng'etuuse ennyama yo n'omubiri gwo we birimalibwawo.
Praise the Lord.
Come ever swear.
This sin of sexual immorality.
Kino ekibi ekyobwenzi.
Brings grief.
Kireeta okunakuwala.
It brings sorrow.
Kireeta ennaku.
To be ridiculed.
Okubanga buli kaseera onakuwala oli wansi.
To be disfavored. It brings disfavor.
Okubanga toliko kuganja.
N'okulekebwawo.
And being rejected.
It causes people to betray you.
Kireetera abantu okubanga bakulyamu enkwe.
You are despised and taken for granted.
Onyomebwa abantu mbakutwala ng'ekintu ekitagasa.
You are abused and never appreciated.
Okozesebwa n'otasiimibwa.
You are irritable.
Obeera onyiiga nyiiga.
And easily angered.
Buli kaseera ovaako waaya.
It causes you to be disorganized.
Kikuleetera okuba nga totebenkera.
Ill-mannered.
Oba n'ebiyisayisa.
Yes, it causes you to be misfashioned, misguided, and it puts you in bondage with wrong people, wrong partners, wrong friends. You seek for wrong advice. And
it's what has taken us to the first prophets.
Proverbs,
Obutali butuukirivu bwe ye buli kwata omubi era alisibibwa n'emigwa egy'okwonoona kwe.
It puts you in bondage. It brings failure in marriage. Failure in businesses. Ministry. Relationships. And godly connections. It hinders your greatness. This sexual sin has bound so many destinies. Has killed so many destinies. I was reading the Bible. I was reading the Bible. Mukama nangamba ekanisa njagala kisumulula mu kibi ekyobwenzi.
And God told me, I want to deliver the church from this scene of
kubanga kirese nabino okwaukana n'okutabukatabuka
has caused
n'okutabulwa
divisions, conflicts. This sin of immorality,
according to Revelation 22:22,
that shall throw you on the sick bed of destruction. That he shall throw you onto the sick bed of
relationships,
and we live the right ways and right relationships. If we don't repent, that one we don't need to cast out
spirits.
We have been dealing with house flies, chasing away house flies, but when we are not cleaning away the dirt, in this issue of Jezebel, we have to repent.
You're taking a responsibility.
You yourself for 12 of us, because you are born in that sin. You are born of your father and your mother. They desire to live the right way of God, and they made themselves to be gods. The Bible says, he who finds a woman to marry, you have to find. When he talks of finding, it means you have to first seek. You don't say, I'm on Kampala Road searching for a partner. You have to go to the Lord. The owner of life who created us in his image. In the right time. Not out of lust.
Praise the Lord.
Not the lust of the flesh. Like how Eve did. For this seed of lust, in Genesis 3 verses 9, we read there. So when the serpent came and deceived her, and then she, the eyes were opened.
Genesis 3:9. Mukama Katonda naayita omusajja n'amugamba nti oli luyiwa. N'ayogera nti mpulidde eddoboozi lyo mu lusuku ne ntya, kubanga mbadde bwereere ne neekweka.
Njagala wali omukyala bwe baamugamba ekibala kirungi. Verse 4, 5.
Olwokuna, omusota ne gamba omukazi nti okufa temulifa, kubanga Katonda amanyi nti olunaku lwe muligulyako mmwe, amaaso gammwe lwe galizibuka, nammwe mulibanga Katonda okumanyanga obulungi n'obubi. Omukazi bwe yalabanga omuti mulungi okulya.
Okawulidde?
Omukazi bwe yalabanga omuti mulungi okulya era nga gusanyusa amaaso n'omuti nga gwakwegombebwa okuleeta amagezi n'anoga ku bibala byagwo n'alya n'awa era ne ku musajja we naye n'alya. Amaaso gaabwe bombi ne gazibuka ne bategeera nga baali bwereere.
Omusota gwe gwabagamba naye Mukama yali yagamba.
So it is a serpent telling them, but
bwe baava ku Mukama kyagamba.
When they left God's command,
ne badda ku bino
and
ebigambo by'omusota.
They were diverted to the words of the serpent.
Naye ate be bennyini be baayogera Mukama yatugamba.
And they were replying to the serpent.
Waliwo disconnection yawo from their maker.
Waliwo okwawukana kw'oyo yabatonda.
The author of life.
Oyo omutandisi w'obulamu.
Bwe batyo ne bava mu lusuku.
And that's how they were cast out of the garden.
Omukyala bwe yalaba. The woman was convinced.
Nto mchala na amatizibwa.
Kale nandi gambye seduced.
Obulya we yasenda sendebwa.
She saw that the tree was beautiful.
Yala ba mtinga mulonji.
And its fruit looked delicious.
Nge bibala byago biwoma.
And she wanted the wisdom it would give her.
Era na yagala amagezi agana ava.
So she took Muchibara, some of it
Muchibara, and
gave to the husband.
Anawako no umami.
So
they all fell away from the vision of God.
Because of
the lust of the eyes, the desire of the flesh.
Today,
we like the present things, not what God wants.
We want material.
Your position, what, no, not what God is telling us.
We
want the results, but we don't want to take responsibility. So we have to take the rod and hit the serpent. But we are just playing around with it. To hit the sin that is entrapped in us.
It is
our responsibility, not God. God has
yatuwa ensigo kye kigambo kye.
He gave us the seed, which is his word,
kye tulina okukozesa okutuzimba,
that we must use to build us,
tufune amaanyi tukube omusota,
to get the power and hit the devil.
Naye n'olwaleero n'ebyawandiikibwa tubifuula kifuula nenge.
But today even we are turning scriptures upside down.
Yatuwa amaanyi, you gave us power to tread upon Satan.
Yatuwa amaanyi okulinya ku misota n'enjaba ez'olusaku,
and over all the powers of the enemy.
N'amaanyi gonna ag'omubi.
When the power of sin is still in you,
ngamanya g'ekibi gakyali mufa gw'okusirokoka.
Eri munze ogwe musoto oguli munze oguleetera sitaani okubeera nga ninako obuyinza ne sibeera na maanyi gatuukiriza Katonda kye yanteeseza.
Ekibi ekiri within me is a serpent that leads me.
Omusota bwe gunkulembera.
When the serpent leads me.
Bwe sikwatagana na Mukama.
And I'm not connected to God.
Bwe sikwatagana na Mwoyo Mutukuvu.
When I'm not connected to the Holy Spirit.
Nga yalina okunnungamya n'okuntwala.
When he is the one to lead me and take me.
Eri omwami omutuufu oba omukyalo omutuufu okubikulya amaaso gange.
Onto the right partner.
Ag'omwoyo si kwegomba kw'emubiri nga siri seduced, siri nga siri siyaka.
When I'm not lasting. All of us, we are products of lust. But praise be to our God, he's restoring us into the family of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He's restoring us.
Never forget the seam.
He's restoring the fallen tabernacle of David.
Because
the nations are waiting for us. And the the world is waiting for the manifestation of the true sons and daughters of God. The true sons of God, those are the ones that are in His image. We are not just using His power, and we are not supposed to be just using His word. His word. In a
way of deception.
So we are
dealing with that sin of immorality and fornication.
The sexual sin damages minds. And it is in charge of bringing madness. It hinders progress and victory. In all you do, however hardworking you are.
So somebody who is born out of by the adulterer is also an adulterer. According to the scripture we have read.
Kati nyizo okubera nga sina yenda.
Maybe I've never committed adultery.
Na your time as long as the sigo yobwenze chandi.
But give me time as long as the seed of adultery is.
Njakwenda.
I will commit adultery.
Ebya marriage bijja kubera bizibu.
And marriage will be a problem.
Atewe binabere bizibu kibategeza family really distorted.
And when I fail in marriage it means
family bwebera distorted ne gwanga.
So when the family is distorted even ministry becomes a problem.
However much anointed I am, when I really
got a dream, even the pastors laid hands on me,
when I'm going
to move in great power to take the gospel to nations, he has not said when they lay hands on me that I shall be delivered out of fornication and adultery.
Yes,
say lest we repent of the adultery of Jezebel, he shall swear that even our lamps.
I've
seen ministers who started in great power.
Pastors,
evangelists, and teachers,
apostles, bishops,
great apostles, great falling down.
At the point of success like this,
mukasera kokubanga batuka kuntiko,
nebagwate webagwa basula banji,
and when they fall they cause many to fall.
Noberango inebibi ebinene.
So when you have those two great
bibiri
things,
kubanga bosula abantu ngo oli waguru osula banji,
whenever you have reached the climax you cause many to fall.
Nayenge kizibu si kya Mukama,
but the problem is not from God.
Sexual sin
kino ekibe ky'obwenzi,
if not dealt with deeply,
if I love the Lord, why can't I sit down and deal with His myself? But we want miracles.
Bible the
Bible has not said when we pray for you and you start dancing around but He has said if you don't repent.
A
repentance is individual.
Praise the Lord.
It is a decision. It is a sign of humility.
Humility is character in a man from God, because Jesus was humble. As
he
told us in Matthew 11:29, that learn of me, I'm meek and humble, meaning that is his character.
But why don't we have that character? We love quick things, outbursting material possessions.
We want a bombastic preacher. The church
feels
bombastic. If
they call us for repentance, a few turn up.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Kakati enough ekanisa.
So us as a church, let's go back and love the Lord.
Restoring
okuzao
the fallen tabernacle of David. That is the theme of this conference. Then Joel 2. From
15.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So the sexual sin
is
the root cause of pain
and
excessive anger.
And
sexual sin is pagan. If not purged,
wetubanga tulongo sedwa mucho.
That anger, ejakuletera anger yoyalemesa Moses.
Obusungu it will hinder you like it hindered Moses.
Being so angry, that excessive anger shows that there is still another God on the throne
in your foundation.
Those who were not here yesterday, we learn where Baal comes from, anger, the spirit of anger. From at the head, Israel. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And Proverbs 5:11, it showed us that this sexual sin is the source of incurable diseases. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Chronic diseases like cancer, AIDS,
asthma.
What?
Sukari.
Sugar diabetes.
Pressure. Amen.
Nabi allergies.
Allergy.
Allergy.
I used to have an allergy. I was always on treatment.
So
if I could please that, then if there's coldness, if there is too much heat, when I eat granuts, and then I looked at my children, it was the same story. And I said, what is this? It can't go on.
By then, we
had not got to the full knowledge. But I asked the Lord. When I asked the Lord, so it was a blood sin.
Sexually transmitted diseases. Sexual sins bring transmitted and those not only STDs but all chronic diseases. Because sexual sin is pagan, there is a God somewhere that was worshipped. I sat down and I stopped the medication.
Natula wansi nendekera okumire eddagala.
Nengamba tujja kusaba.
And I said, let's pray.
Nga mmere ebirogorogo nebiturika.
So I could go.
Nebizimba nebiberamu amazzi nga byocha.
I could get gross on my body and they burst out with water.
N'abaana nabo nga bwe batyo.
Likewise to the children.
Kati nendiringa nacho mukwenenya.
I dealt with it this rule.
Bwenenenya genda wala buziba.
So when I went deep into repentance, they don't go instantly.
Bisoka nebibera resistant.
They first hesitate.
Bo bitandika ko nebyeyongera.
And when you begin on they meaning that they are spirits.
Biri stubborn. Jezebel is stubborn.
Jezebel is a stubborn spirit.
So the
church we have been dealing with is house fries. But we have not dealt with the origin of sin.
Which is frustrating.
Sin frustrates life. The sexual sin.
It
brings blindness.
It
causes deaf ear to the Lord. For you not hearkening to the Lord, you want to do your own
desire.
You are serving another God. God wants us to take our idols. He wants us to take our images. And the reason why you don't go to the Lord, because you know he will cast out some things that you want. You want to remain with him. When you are still worshiping worshiping the idol. Because it's like God lays.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So this sexual sin, it's behind all murder and bloodshed. And it makes you a vagabond. Proverbs 7 verse
11.
Anyone here and gocha struggling and okwaka.
You're still struggling with okwaka
ponango yakira ebintu ebitali bibyo oyakira abakazi oyakira
abasajja. You lust for women, you lust for men, you lust for things which don't belong to you.
Ngatoina self control.
Ngatoifungako.
Osobola nokubba.
You can even steal.
Noba nechimu echekumi.
Even steal the tithe.
Obbe chiwebwayo.
You steal the offering.
It's pagan.
Worship
of other gods.
Of all sins are
cataclysm.
Not being established and rooted in righteousness.
Ngero musanvu kumi na rumu. Muyombi era mukakanyavu. Ebigere bye tebibeera mu nyumba ye. Oluusi aba mu nguudo, oluusi mu bifo ebigazi. Era ategera ku buli mugguukiriro. Awo n'amukwata n'amunywegera n'amugamba ng'amusimbye amaaso nti saddaaka ez'ebiweebwayo olw'emirembe ziri wange.
Okay. Olaba nti nno Jezebeli mugundi gwennyini.
She's seductive.
Tatereera.
She's never stable.
Ky'ova olaba ng'oli muyombi nnyo.
That's why you're so quarrelsome.
Anti bye ebikolwa bya Jezebeli. Oli muyombi, oli muvumi.
You are so quarrelsome, you are so abusive.
Okuyomba n'okuvuma kwakuganirako.
We have hesitated with abusing and quarreling.
Oli chana cha Satani, chana cha Jezebel.
You are a brood of viper, an offspring of Jezebel.
It is time to deal with this.
Chechi say that to dealing in a church.
So this sexual sin robs you of authority.
Chinechevicho wenzichi chukujako
obiinza. Godly prosperity.
No kula kula no kubwa katonda.
Abo Uganda ne Satani agaba ebintu.
Brethren, even the devil gives prosperity.
Okumanya agaba ebintu.
So you can't refute that.
Matthew 4. Verse 11. Okay, he told Jesus. He took him at the mountain. And he showed Jesus the kingdoms. The glamour. And he told him, please worship me and I'll give it to you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Well, prosperity is good. But is it godly? So, kachino omusota gwe gubanga gwe gukuwadde gumanyi nti gujja kubojja at the end of the day.
So, if it is a serpent providing at the end of the day, it is going to bite you.
It will rob you. It has the authority of robbing you.
We know we use wokunya ngako byonna.
Era bino byatugamba banange nze jjajja wa fefe bola batwali bagagga obugagga bwali bwa Katonda.
And this comprehend that I know our forefathers were rich, but was it prosperity from God? Your father had 3 wives.
Okay, basatu wainzo gamba banji. Kale babiri.
Okay, yaina, he had 2.
Obane gwe yainanga tayari uwe.
Oh, even the one he had loved him.
Newakubate bazala abana 12.
Though he produced 12 of children.
Nze munange fetwa our mother and our father in one word.
Nga fena tuli bana ba mchalo omu na tato omu.
Na yenga batu obufumbo nga mukama ye yabagatta.
But is it God who joined them in marriage?
Oba muli bana ba benzi.
Oh, you are children of fornicators.
Bible yagamba nti ayenda ku mukazi taina magezi.
The Bible says who commits for adultery with a woman.
Today tuchirabe.
Let's go back. And the one who robs somebody's wife.
Kati fena. All of us. Victims.
We are all victims. In this matter, we need to repent and cleanse ourselves very well. And we leave the crowd of suffering. It is good to sleep in a bed when you
have godly visions and dreams.
When you are peaceful, when you are peaceful. And when you have the peace of God.
But when the devil gives you,
you can never have peace. And there is no addition always. You work toil hard, but and you have no strength to maintain.
You will end up in this discouragement. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
This sexual sin takes away God's presence and desire for His word. It robs you of fellowship with the right people and the company of God's people. It only gives you desire for worldly pursuits and ambitions. It makes you an enemy of God. It makes you hard-hearted and quarrelsome. It robs you of godly peace, patience and love. It is hard for a person who is still bound by this sexual sin to be forgiving. Proverbs 6.
Engeresula mukaga.
From 24.
Tanikira kwa biri munya.
Engera mukaga biri munya. Okukumanga eri omukazi omubi eri okunyumiriza ku lulimi lw'omugenyi. Teweegombanga bulungi bwe mutima gwo, so n'ebikowe bye biremenga okukukwasa. Kubanga olw'omukazi omwenzi, omuntu afuuka mmere bumere. N'omukazi omwenzi ayigga obulamu obw'omuwendo omungi. Omuntu ayinza okuwambatira omuliro mu kifuba kye, ebyambalo bye ne bitajja. Oba omuntu ayinza okutambulira mu manda agookya, ebigere bye ne bitasiriira. Bw'atyo bw'abeera ayingira eri omukazi wa munne. Buli amukomako talirema kubonerezebwa.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Kati waliwo ebibonoobono bye tulimu.
So there are sufferings that we are in.
Nga bakitaffe ne bajjajjaffe.
When our fathers and forefathers.
Bayagala abakyala abatali baabwe.
They loved the wives who were not theirs.
Tebaanoonya Mukama.
They never sought the Lord.
Kuba connectinga.
To connect them.
Nambirizi zaabwe.
With their right ribs.
Kati okubonaabona konna.
So all the suffering.
Aha, malaya awo kupaka kwa satu mu. Satu.
Olwa satu. Abantu tebanyooma mubbi oba ngabba okukusa ememe ye ng'alumiddwa enjala. Naye bw'anaalabikanga anaagattanga emirundi musanvu, anaawangayo ebintu byonna eby'omu nnyumba ye. Ayenda ku mukazi talina kutegeera. Ayagala okuzikiriza obulamu bwe ye yakola bw'atyo. Asatu musatu. Alifuna ebiwundu n'okunyoomebwa n'ekivume kye tekirisangulibwa.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ekivume kye kikola ki?
His reproach will not be wiped away.
Kati byonna kivume kukola ki?
Reproach, disgrace.
Mu kifo ky'okwekwasa abantu.
Instead of blaming people. We take it away by repentance. You might think you are right, but the foundations of your birth. Time has come.
Ngabwatugambye mu Revelation 18.
As he has told us, from verse
3 to 9. Kino kye kiseera ekyokuba Jezebel.
This is the time to deal with Jezebel.
Ngatumusiga okulula nga twawukana naye n'ebikolwa bye okuviira ddala.
Separating from her deeds right from.
Okuyita mu mulandira gw'obwenzi n'obukaba.
Through the root of fornication and adultery.
This spirit.
Omwoyo guno.
Oba this sin.
Oba kino ekibi.
Has caused many bitter lives. Hatred for one another, jealous and revenge, and resentment. People with this spirit don't sit together. Even in ministry, I've seen it.
It hinders people to work together and teamwork.
I've seen it bringing downfalls and causing pitfalls. For many good people, good women and good men of God. And it is pagan. It is impure. Let's see 1 Thessalonians 4 from 3 to 6. We are going to repent from this sin and we will see a difference in our lives. The Bible says in righteousness you shall be established. And today, if there has been unrighteousness and that sin has been deeply rooted, we have been deeply rooted.
I think that it was in Bamuchibecho.
You know
yourself.
Abasesalonikekisooka nya olwokusatu. Kubanga olwokubiri. Kubanga mumanyi ebiragiro bwe biri byetwabalagira ku bwa Mukama waffe Yesu. Kubanga ekyo Katonda kyayagala okutukuzibwa kwammwe okwewalanga obwenzi. Olwokuna, buli muntu kummwe okumanyanga okufuga omubiri gwe ye mu butukuvu n'ekitiibwa. Si mu mululu ogw'okwegomba era ng'amawanga agatamanyi Katonda alemenga okuyingirira muganda we newankubadde okumusobyako mu kigambo ekyo. Kubanga Mukama waffe awalana eggwanga eri ebyo byonna era nga bwe twasooka okubabuulira n'okutegeereza ddala.
Buli muntu kirungi okwewalanga ki?
It is good to put away.
Bwenzi bukaba kwaka.
Last morality fornication.
Kwaka kw'omubiri, kwaka
kw'ebintu.
Kutujje ku Mukama.
It has taken us away from God.
Nekutuletera okusinza bikatonda
bano. And has caused us to worship other gods.
Netugwa mu bitimba.
And we have fallen into snares.
Wakubanga tubadde tetumanyi.
As though we are in ignorance.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
Kati netubeera nga tuliko rejection.
So we had rejection.
Ebintu bitutuseeko ministry.
So we have become vagabonds in ministry. We never settle. We are not established. We are not strengthened. We don't wait upon the Lord. The fruit of the Holy Spirit. Though we speak about them, or we have. They are not attending the church. Why?
Bichari mukanisa ngate ebibale ebyomoyo nge kanisa batuyita balokole naye ng'obulokozi tebulabisibwa.
They call us born again, but the salvation is not seen among us.
It is because of this omulandira guno.
Shiva ku this root
of sexual sin that is not
uprooted. And you don't just uproot, you have to repent. So repentance is a very big cause.
Psalms 106.
Zaburi
10:9.
Zaburi 10:39.
Zaburi 10:39. Bwe batyo ne babaako empitambi olw'emirimu gyabwe ne bagenda ne bagenda bayenda mu bikolwa byabwe.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Ekanisa.
So the church had a fierceness of sexual immorality. Immorality with other gods.
No wenzi buno bwo kwaka.
And this immorality of lusting.
Ngatete tuchimanyi nti no twaka.
And we are not aware that we are lusting.
Ato kwaka kubera mutima.
And lusting is always from the heart.
Katonda ayagala mutima.
And God is interested in this.
Ayagala tupajing.
He wants to okutulongosa.
Naye nga tuyina okukimanya.
But we must get aware.
Tukiriziganye naye.
Or at least agree with him.
1 Corinthians 6.
From
18.
From
18. Sembai upaka malak paka kuruabi.
Up to 20.
Bakolinsi ekisooka mukaaga kumi na munana.
Oba nedda va ku lwomukaaga ku lwomwenda.
Start from verse 9.
Bakolinsi ekisooka mukaaga mwenda. Oba temumanyi nga abatali batuukirivu tebali sikira bwakabaka bwa Katonda.
Okalabyako.
You can see that.
Obwakabaka bubadde butulema.
So we could not possess the kingdom.
Bakanise banga dene na inga tetuli mu bwakabaka.
We have been in the church for a long time but not in the kingdom.
Kubanga tetubadde batukiri.
Because we have not been righteous.
Temuli mbibwanga ne wankubadde abakaba ne wankubadde abasinze ebifaananyi ne wankubadde abenzi ne wankubadde abafuuka abakazi ne wankubadde abali ebisiyaga ne wankubadde ababbi ne wankubadde abeegombi ne wankubadde abatamiivu ne wankubadde abavumi ne wankubadde abanyazi tebali sikira bwakabaka bwa Katonda era abamu ku mmwe mwali ng'abo naye mwanaazibwa. Naye mwatukuzibwa, naye mwaweebwa obutuukirivu olw'erinnya lya Mukama waffe Yesu Kristo n'olw'omwoyo gwa Katonda waffe.
Praise the Lord.
Gamba amen.
We need another spirit.
Twetaaga omwoyo omulala.
If we do not repent of this one,
bwe tuba nga tetwenenyeza kino
ekyokibi
ky'obwenzi bulungi,
the spirit of God,
omwoyo wa Katonda
can hardly sit in us.
Tasobola kutuula mu ffe.
We can hardly bear fruit.
Tetusobola kubala bibala.
Ne era ekibi kiba kituwangula.
And the other one will be overcoming
us. Kubanga amaanyi g'ekibi gaba gakyali mu ffe, omusota bwe guba nga gukyalimu.
If the serpent is still inside.
Obusagwa n'ebigenderako byonna 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 byebiba bimba.
Venom and poisonous will be coming out of us.
Katugenda kwenenya olw'ebibi bino.
So we're going to repent of these sins.
You are lusts.
Okwaka.
Adultery.
Obwenzi.
Fornication.
Obukaba.
Prostitution.
Obwamalayo.
Uncontrollable desire for sex.
Obutefunga mu by'okwedaga.
Yes.
Byokwegatya.
Masturbation.
Okwematiza.
Sex outside marriage.
Okubanga oyenda wabweru w'obufumbo.
Watching pornography.
Okubanga olaba ebifaanana ebyobukaba.
We're going to repent of watching nudity.
Tugenda kubanga twenenya olw'okulaba ebifaanana ebibi.
And blue movies.
Okulaba ababali obwerire.
People.
Bantu mwe
olwaleero
today
tebiriiko basajja bakulu tebiriiko bafumbo tebiriiko baki.
None is mature, none is old, none is professional.
Esimu zitulemye okufuga.
We have failed to control our phones.
Era bwe tuba tetwenenyeza.
And at least we will repent.
Esimu zitufuze era zibadde miryango.
So the phones have controlled us and have been gates.
Okusiikuula kyekyo.
To stir up the other spirit.
Kati o Jezebel.
Now, Yezebe. Together with our phones.
Ha, chakabi.
It has become so strong.
Abavubuka.
The young men.
Naba, tuabakurubo, naba,
even old people, they are all victims. Because we don't repent properly this root of this harlot. It has taken us out. All our minds. They are lasting.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Naye Bible egambye tomanyi nti nno nti atali mutukuvu tali sikira bwakabaka.
The Bible says, don't you know that the unrighteous shall not inherit?
Olw'ekumi n'omunana n'olw'ekumi n'omwenda ne lugamba lutya?
And verses 18 and 19 said what?
First Corinthians 6.
Olw'ekkumi n'omunaana. Mwewalenga obwenzi. Buli kibi kyonna omuntu kyakola kiri kungulu ku mubiri. Naye ayenda akola ekibi ku mubiri gwe ye. Oba temumanyi ng'omubiri gwammwe ye yeekaalu y'Omwoyo Omutukuvu ali mu mmwe gwe mulina eyava eri Katonda.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Omwoyo Omutukuvu ava eri Katonda. Bwe tuba tetulina Mwoyo Omutukuvu ava eri Katonda.
If we don't have the Holy Spirit from God,
tulina Jezebel.
Then we have Jezebel's spirit.
Jezebel twalabye gwe musota guli.
We have seen that she is a serpent.
Ogunyirira.
Outside it is beautiful.
Mwatugutu wa magezi.
It gives us wisdom.
Buli byonna byokola.
And all things that you do.
Nga tofunye magezi ga Katonda.
And you don't have the wisdom of God.
Jezebel.
God expects me and you to be that church that bruises a serpent. We have no excuse whatsoever. Because the word of God is available and is a seed. And he says, the accuser, the blasphemer.
Naye tumuwangula olw'omusaayi gw'omwana gw'endiga.
But we overcome him by the blood of the lamb.
N'olw'ekigambo ekiri okutegeeza.
And by the word of our testimony.
Tugenda kwenenya olwa incest.
We're going to repent olw'okwegatta okw'okumubika ne families.
Byonna biri mu bloodline zaffe.
All that is through Messiah Jesus.
Tugenda kwenenya olwa homosexuality.
We're going to repent olw'ebisiaga.
Lesbianism.
Obusego bw'abakyala.
Rape.
Okukwata
abakyala. As long as they are in our families.
Ebyo byonna mwebanga biri mu bika byaffe ne famili zaffe.
This snake is still at work.
Omusota guno gwoba gukyafuga.
The church is you and me.
Ekkanisa yegwe nange.
We are the temple of the Holy Spirit.
Yeffe yeekaalu y'Omwoyo Omutukuvu.
To bring the kingdom of God in our families.
Okuleeta obwakabaka bwa Katonda mu famili zaffe.
We are going to repent of oral sex bestiality.
Tugenda kuwenenya okwegatta n'ebisolo.
Group sex, public sex.
Aba bantu abeegatira mu bigurupu.
Using sex toys.
Abeegatira mu nkungano bimansiro abakozesa ebitooyi okwegatta nabyo.
Those luring and seduction.
Abo abasendasenda.
Enticing people.
Okubanga okyamukiriza abantu.
All perversions.
N'okukyamizibwa kwonna.
And all sexual behaviors.
N'empisa zonna ezikwatagana n'obukaba.
Are all pagan.
Byonna bya Katonda.
And we saw in Jeremiah 23.
Era twalabye mu Yeremiya 23.
Verse 10 and 11, read there.
Olw'okumi n'ekumi n'omu katudde mutusomeyo. Yeremiya 23, olw'okumi n'ekumi n'omu.
Yeremiya 23 olw'ekkumi. Kubanga ensi ejjudde abenzi. Kubanga ensi ekungubaga olw'okulayira. Amalundiro ag'omu ddungu gakaze. N'amagenda gaabwe mabi. N'amaanyi gaabwe si malungi. Kubanga nnabbi era ne kabona boonoonefu. Weewaawo mu nnyumba yange mwe nalabira obubi bwabwe. Bwayogera Mukama.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tugenda kusoka kubyenenya mu nyumba ya Mukama.
So we shall begin with repentance in the house of the Lord.
Bino byonna mu kanisa mwebiri.
All this is happening in the church.
Nga tetunalaba kanisa kiri ekizimbo oba kino ekibaati, nze kanisa.
Before we looked at the church building.
Agambye nti ensi yonna eyonoonese n'egwa eddalu.
He says all the earth is
meaning profane. Tukyenenya ku personal level.
So okyenenyeza ku ddala ly'obuntu.
Family level.
Eddala lya family.
Ne tukyenenya ku region.
And all immorality in the whole world. The church we are responsible.
So this is what the Bible says, that my
house shall be a house of prayer for all nations. Right from beginning with Israel. And all the body of Christ. This church shall go spring forth. All nations have
prayed
because of immorality and all acts of immorality. All that is in us. If the church repents, we shall have beaten quickly.
Ekkanisa bw'etakifaako.
If the church doesn't take
care. Agambye mbu amagenda.
He says destinies.
Destinies are destroyed.
Amagenda gajja kuzikirira.
If we do not deal with this sexual sin.
Bwe tubanga
All the curses and it's the open door and destroying families.
When you don't repent even that small family of yours will be destroyed.
There is no legacy.
Because
it is
the serpent has no family. And doesn't love families. And destroys families. It destroyed your family. And even the church family has been destroyed. There is no God in our midst. Everybody is bad behavior. Everyone doesn't love the other. Everyone doesn't forgive the other. Everybody blames the other. This one takes himself
superior.
This one doesn't obey the other.
There is no submission. And there is no future. If we do not deal with it. If it is not dealt with. There is no hope for nations. No hope for the future. For any nation. And it is the church that is supposed to deal with it. However great and powerful you will become over ministry, over minister. However powerful you are, bishop or
bishop or reverend or archbishop,
you will collapse. The great collapse we see today in churches and ministries, because you have refused to crush the serpent. Nations are in chaos and crumbling because of this principality. The church is the one that God has given the power and authority. We will not operate in the authority that is granted unto us.
We shall just be shouting when we have no work, when we are just shouting, as it has been in the past. Churches are all about receiving miracles. We receive for miracles when we are not children. We receive miracles, but we continue with the fights. There is no purpose of Christ.
Praise the Lord.
Gamba amina.
Anyway, omoyo guno.
So this spirit,
we thank
God that He has given us the authority.
Luke 10:19. He said that I have given you power to tread on snakes and scorpions.
Luka 10:19. Laba mbawadde obuyinza obw'okulinnyanga ku misota n'enjaba ez'obusagwa n'amaanyi gonna ag'omulabe, so tewali kintu ekinaabakola nga obubi n'akatono.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It has taken us to wrong people. It has led us to wrong partners. It has led us to wrong churches. And it has led us to wrong destinies.
It has taken us out of destiny.
Misleading.
And has misled us.
Kakati ogenda kukwata mtubacho.
So you shall touch into your apostle.
Gamba ayesu.
Ayesu.
Nkwebaza.
Tukwebaza.
Olwenkolagana.
Olwenkolagana.
Yange nawe.
Yange nawe.
N'okudda obujja.
Mu
conference eno.
Mu conference.
Nga bwe twalabye.
Nga bwe twalabye.
Mu bikolwa by'abatume.
Bikolwa by'abatume.
15.
15.
Okuva ku nyolwe 16.
Okuva ku nyolwe 16.
Paka ku lwe 17.
Paka ku lwe 17.
N'olwe 18.
N'olwe 18.
Wakiraba.
Wakiraba.
Nti tugenda, nti tulimenyeka.
Nti tulimenyeka.
Nti weema gye wazimba.
Weema gye wazimba.
Erigwa.
Erigwa.
Naye gw'olina plan.
Naye gw'olina plan.
Okuddamu
okuzimba.
In your own words, repent. There is grace and power to change, to overcome. If it is demons, see God. As we have seen in John chapter
2,
from verses 25, he's taking off from shame.
The shame that is irremovable.
He's getting away by repenting. Repent deeply. In your own words, the Bible says, when I came inside, your seed and my bones, they got
all.
For the seed that sits in me. But when I but whenever when I confessed my sin, you stood from heaven and you forgave my unrighteousness. And for that matter, whoever fears God, you let him confess their unrighteousness, their sin, that of us, that of sexual immorality. Father, I've understood. It has been a
great
and it has been a great
blow
for me to cause. To fail,
okuswazibwa,
to be ashamed, and repent for fornication, and repent for rusting, the eyes in the public, in my heart, and repent for worship other gods. Repent, O God, as a church. We repent as greater works for the sin of immorality and for homosexuality.
Prostitution.
They are in our nation. But the church, we have been not caring. We repent for pride. Instead of looking at you,
and
we look at the cross, and you reveal to us the reproach of immorality in our nation, being upon Israel, and all the world. Father, the joy and the song
have
not been around in our midst. We repent, as you have said, in Jeremiah, verse 34. That I will not be joy in marriage for this sin, that we never repented. We repent for our children. There will not be the song of marriage apart from you if you help us. But we
feel
this spirit
of
procession. Prostitution has been in me. Me, I personally, according to the clan I come from, the family I come from, and the house I come from, and where I grew up, the side of my husband. I repent for the incest. I repent for not seeing things the way you see them, because my eyes had blinded unto righteousness. And it has been
hard
for the kingdom
to
be open for me.
But
I have been in the church. But when I'm blind, I don't see the way of blessing. I don't see the way of salvation. The kingdom, have mercy. Have mercy. Have forgive us as a church. As forgive us for the lodges. For the lodges around and the bars, and the bars that we have not cared about. Have mercy, Lord.
Justice.
And that's why we don't have justice
in the courts of law.
Judiciary.
You know about the injustice.
For the cause as a church, we have not committed ourselves. Your word, tetukitwala
we could not take it as a great issue.
Ekitabo kya Matayo
in the book of Matthew
sura 5
chapter 5
verses
27 and 28 Bible says
nti toyendanga
nemba komita
ndagane nkadde
naye
ate mundagane mpya
but in the old
no gamba
you say
tino yatunulira omukazi
the one who lusts at a woman
namwegomba
and lusts at her
abera yenzi
has committed adultery.
Mukama tubadde twenda
Father we have been lusting with our eyes.
Tubadde twaka
we have been lusting. We lust at men. We lust at
women.
We lust at material
things.
We lust at
honors.
We love honors.
They
have hindered us in the church. There is no submission. Everybody despises the other. Everybody abuses the other. Everybody mocks the other. We want to be
self-exalted.
We fight for honors. We love the
truth.
We want to preach at the
point,
but
transformation
and the fear and the fear
of Jesus,
you are meek. We never love that character. Have mercy. Forgive us. Father, we had made churches entertainment centers. We want to show off. We want to show clothing. We want to show titles. We want to show what we have. We lust at machines and other outside things. Instead of dealing with important issues, we have left the issue of your kingdom, building our own empire. And you missed in our
presence.
Services are both showing off and showing how we can preach. We love so much the message. We have been messengers. But the messages we don't have. The messages from you. We speak what we desire. We preach what we desire. The interesting words. What favors us. That's what we seek for. All that is
last.
We tolerated the serpent. We have prayed with it. Instead of using it, it's a reason. We have not been with power. It's a reason. We have not prospered. It's a reason. We have not. The gates of our enemies, they have conquered us. The earth has overcome. The agents of the devil. We have embraced them. We sit with them. We admire them. All that is lasting. The last of material things. The last of everything.
Pleasures of this world. Have taken over your authority. Have taken us over. No wonder we do not have authority. Jesus said
in
Matthew 11. Verse 27. That all authority and power has been given. But I'm meek and humble. We have not given you our burdens because we think going to the sacred place is taking long. We have lusted after other gods. Material gain. Material pleasures.
It's what we have been boasting about. We had neglected your image.
We have been a fallen tabernacle. We need revival. We need rehabilitation. Break us. Make us new.
Mokama tufula abaja.
Make us afresh.
Tufula abapya.
Rebuild us.
Tuzimbe nate.
Break.
Tumenye.
We have wasted a lot of time.
Mokama tono nye bisera
bingi. And yes.
Neniaka.
On things.
Ubintu.
That you did not send us.
Ubintu biyota tumira kola.
You told us to occupy until you come.
Watugamba tubereho paka wona ajira.
But without authority in your image.
Nate katutuina buiza mukifanani icho.
We didn't have authority, we didn't have power. Because we have been dancing with the serpent. We have been playing with
Jezebel.
We have been tolerating
Jezebel.
Instead of embracing your spirit, it has been Jezebel. We admit. And we repent. We repent. Can we repent on behalf of Israel?
Katufukamine twenenye ku lwa
Israel. Israel is the firstborn of God.
Israel ye muberebere wa Katonda.
And we have not been praying for you, Israel.
Ate tupade tusabira Israel.
As Ugandans.
Ngaba na Uganda.
It's our responsibility.
Uvunanzibwa bwa fe.
Israel is where we connect from.
Israel we tweyungira.
It's the modern nation.
Ye gwangirira bibwa ko maso ga Katonda.
For government to be stable.
Amawanga government okubeya estebenkede.
Israel has to be positioned.
Israel tekedo kwa mchifo chayo.
And aligned. And it is the church.
Ereke kanisa.
That is supposed to pray for Israel.
Ye tekedo kusabira Israel.
It's we Ugandans.
Ye feba na Uganda.
Who are supposed to pray for Israel.
But we had
neglected our responsibility. Because Isaiah
9.
The Bible says that all leaders have transgressed. But because from the head. Which head is
Israel?
And the church is supposed to bring God's governance. His rule, Christ's rule and reign. And bring justice. And law and order. From the word of God. From the presence of God. But Lord, we admit that we did not mind about your presence. We have been so much mindful of building the physical temple. And we neglected the spiritual temple. We have been stupid builders. Please forgive us. We did not mind about praying for Israel. That's why we have not been aligned. Forgive us, Lord. Where we have neglected your word. We have been blind. Blind guides. Blind leaders. The leaders, both the leaders and the followers. We have all been blind. We
are,
instead of making disciples. Oh, we have been having members. Chasing after crowds. Forgive us, Lord. Forgive the shepherds. Forgive the leaders. Forgive
Israel.
Forgive the nations. We have not crushed the serpent. We have danced with it. We admit and we confess. Now we come back to the heart of worship. And now we bring back Israel into your bosom. And we bring back the nations. The Arab nations. The wars that are going on, Lord. Because of this principality,
Jezebel.
May you reach out as you helped us Ugandans, as you helped us the church to understand. Help the nations. Simply come.
from far and near.
Thank you.